Hey everyone, April here. Welcome back to my channel where we talk all things Power Platform and Microsoft 365. This week, I'm continuing my review of the three new Dataverse for Teams Power Apps templates. Last week, I gave you an overview of the Profile Plus template, and this week, I'm going to be showing you the Perspectives template. If you're looking for a way that you can curate a list of topics that you would track discussions on, then this is a template for you. For those of you who may come from a SharePoint background like myself, you might have used the discussion board templates in SharePoint in the past. This application is actually a good replacement for that. As always, I'll walk you through how you get this set up and how it works right after this. To install the Perspectives template, you're going to go to aka.ms/teams-perspectives. That will take you here to the GitHub repo where the source code is stored. If you look under the right, under releases, you should see the latest release there, so all you need to do is click on that. And just like with the Profile Plus template that we looked at last week, we'll have two different versions. We'll have the Teams custom app version, which will allow for easy deployment natively into Teams. Or we have the Dataverse solution if you wanted to use this, say maybe outside of Dataverse, and you want the ability to control the entire solution. As I did last week, we're going to look at the Teams custom app installation because that is the smoothest installation experience out of the two. Just click on the zip file and that will prompt a download of the file on your desktop. And now we're going to open up Microsoft Teams and click on the app tab in the left rail. We'll choose the upload a custom app option in the bottom left. And choose either upload for me and my teams if you want to upload that for a specific group or team, or upload for my org if you want to upload this as a tenant-wide application. So I'll just choose upload for my org, and then we'll navigate to that zip file that we just downloaded. I can see that that's been added here because there's a tile for perspective. So now if I want to install it, all we need to do is click on that perspectives tile and select add to a team. Then it will prompt us to select the team that we want to add this to. I'll choose our HR team and then set up a tab. I'll uncheck the post to a channel about this option and then click save. And now it will go through the setup process. Once it finishes installing here, we're going to click allow to allow this application to connect to the Teams and the Office 365 users connectors. And one of the great things about all of these templates that you'll notice is it gives you some sample data so that you can see what it looks like from the start. So as I said in the intro there, the Perspectives app is really just a discussion board type template. So on the home screen here, we can organize our discussions around different topics. So as you see, we have a topic for diversity and inclusion, where we can see what the topic is, a little bit more information about that topic, and then even how many discussions we have for that given topic. So in this case, we have 6 predefined discussions inside the diversity and inclusion topic. And then we can see the other topics like hiring, career, power apps, and just for fun. Now, if we scroll down, we see we have 2 buckets. We have new discussions and most active discussions. So this is using some filtering behind the scenes. So in the new discussions, it's going to take any of the most recently added discussions and surface the top 3 of those here. And then for the most active, it's going to see which discussions have the most likes and the most comments and replies and surface the top 3 of those here in the most active discussions bucket. We can easily see with each of these discussions which topic it belongs to. So in this case, this one's Power Apps, and this one's Diversity and Inclusion. And we can see how many comments or replies to the discussion there are, and how many likes, and we can even upvote or like this particular discussion right from the screen by clicking this button here. So if we go into one of these discussions, like maybe does anybody know any dad jokes, we'll see who initially started the discussion, and then all other responses below. And these responses can be sorted by oldest to newest, newest to oldest, and most helpful. So this is another cool feature of the discussion board. When we have a reply to a discussion like this, we can click this thumbs up to mark that particular discussion as helpful, and that will help it rank higher in the discussion replies. So we can thumbs up the discussion itself here in the top right by this icon, and we can mark particular replies as helpful. And you see when I click that reply there and marked it helpful, it gave it this tag in the upper right-hand corner of recommended with my profile picture associated with it. So that's letting people know that are looking through the discussion that I said that this is a recommended reply. And we can reply to a discussion by clicking on the add response button. And we have a rich text field that pops open here. So I'll put one of my favorite dad jokes in here. Why don't crabs give to charity? Because they're shellfish. I'm going to add my response. And we see it get added below in the list of responses. So this is an informal, kind of silly use case of the perspectives template and the discussion board type functionality. But you can see how this could be very powerful from a company knowledge management and Q&A type perspective. If we go into, say, the Power Apps topic here back on the home screen, we'll be able to see all of the discussions related to Power Apps. So this is where if you wanted to use it in a more traditional Q&A knowledge base type application, it'll be really helpful. So if you want to harness the internal knowledge of people in your company that might know a lot about Power Apps, and you might have questions that come up like what we're seeing here, how do I use Power Apps with more than one user? Or how do I track inspections? Or should we create records in Power Apps or Power Automate? Questions that people might have. You can curate those questions in here and then have the experts or people in your company reply to those. And then based on the replies, we can mark those as recommended so people know that that is the correct answer. So if I go into this first one, how do I use Power Apps with more than one user? We'll see a reply here. And if I mark that one as helpful, that's going to have that recommended flag there with my picture associated with it, letting people know that that is a recommended answer. So if any of you have maybe used the Power Users forums and the discussion board functionality offered in there, or any kind of discussion board type functionality for that matter, most discussion boards give you the ability to mark a particular response as the answer or the recommended answer, which is what we're doing there. And of course, we have the ability at any given time for any of the topics that we have here in the replies to edit them by clicking on the pencil next to that. So if I needed to change the question here in the discussion, I can do that. And I can even delete it if it's no longer relevant or I created it by mistake or whatever it might be. And then the same thing for my reply. I can always come back in, edit that, and delete it if I need to. Back on the home screen, if we want to create more topics that people can have discussions around, we can select the Add a Topic button. And there's only three things that we have to fill out here: the topic name, a description, and then we can associate an image or an icon with that that will show up there on that home screen. So I might create a topic for SharePoint, for example, and we can even upload images that we might have on our desktop or somewhere else by clicking the Add New and selecting the image from there. Or we can even associate an icon. If we switch over to that icon property, we have a few pre-built in icons that we can select from. Then just click Save, and now we have that topic added here so people can create discussions around that. And of course, we have some built-in searching, so the more topics that you start to curate in this, the bigger it will get. So we can easily search for a particular topic. If I know I'm wanting help on Power Apps, I can just search for that. It's going to filter those topics, and then I can dive into that topic and explore all the discussions and start a new discussion. Now, for new discussions, there are two different ways that we can start that. So if I want to ask something or have a discussion around Power Apps, I can click the New Discussion button and just give it a title and some context. So maybe I want to get people's feedback and opinions on how to choose the best data source for your app. So I can say I'm struggling to figure out what data source is best for my app. Any advice would be helpful. So I'll click Save, and that will add that as a new discussion within the Power Apps topic. And then I can go into it and add a response like we did with the dad jokes topic. The other way that we can start discussions, though, is from importing it from a Teams conversation. So you see this existing Teams conversation option here? If we click that, we're actually able to put in a link to a Teams conversation and assign a title and some context to that. Now, this will work for conversations that you have within a particular Teams channel. So right now, I have this deployed in the general channel of our HR team. So maybe in the recruiting channel, I was having some kind of conversation here that's relevant to one of those topics in the Perspective app. What I can do is go to that channel, and next to the conversation within the Teams channel, I can click on the three dots, and you'll see an option for copy link. Now I can copy a link to this conversation. So I'm going to select that, and we'll go back to the Perspective app, and we'll go, say, into the diversity and inclusion topic. Let's do the From Existing Teams Conversation option, and we'll put that conversation link in here. And we'll call this maybe employee morale. So maybe I'm asking what are ways we can increase employee morale. And we'll click Save on this one. One of the things that I really like about these Dataverse for Teams templates that they release is there's some great documentation along with it that explains the overall architecture and how the application is set up. On the docs.microsoft.com site, which I'll provide a link to here in the video notes, for each of the templates here that they create, you'll see that they have a corresponding sample app architecture document. So we can see the overall model of how this particular template is architected. We can see that the data is stored inside of Dataverse, and these are the underlying tables that are created where the data is stored. We see that it does connect to the Office 365 users connector to provide person details and profile picture that's used inside of the application. And it even defines the inputs and the outputs of the app. The inputs being able to create a topic, create a discussion, create a response, and flag helpful messages. And outputs being the ability to read topics, read discussions, and read responses. It'll even go as far as showing the data model so you can see with the individual tables there in Dataverse how they're all related. And if you keep scrolling down, you can see a full list of all of the collections used, the global variables, details of what code is running on start and what it's doing, and details about what each screen is doing as well. So if you decide you want to make any tweaks to the template to maybe add additional functionality or change things up, you'll definitely want to review this architecture document so that you can understand what's happening behind the scenes. Now, speaking of extension points or tweaking the template, one thing that I could see right off the bat is it provides a way to mark a particular reply as helpful, but what if you need to have some moderation in there? What if a reply is inappropriate or needs to be flagged for someone to review? That's something that you could add into this template as well. I know this is one of the most highly requested templates that the team had, so really happy to see it done and put into use here. There's so many great use cases from, again, just informal discussions and getting feedback and perspectives on things to help desk in knowledge base type situations. So that's all that I really have for you all today. If you install this template and use it, let me know what you think and drop a note in the comments. And as always, if you found this video helpful, please do me a favor, hit that like, share, and subscribe. And I'll catch you in the next video.